it's Brian Lord, and it has been a long, long, long time, and I'm sorry for that, but I guess it situations that were out of my control prevented me from, you know, hanging out with you guys. Oh, man. I love recording, to be honest, but just have not been able to do it the past couple months, but I've been working on it, and yeah. So, yeah, today we're just going to be kind of update on, I'm just going to kind of update you guys on, you know, what the channels have been, or what's been wrong, kind of fill you in, and then kind of talk about what we're going to move on towards. And, you know, there's, you might notice the video is a little long for probably just an update video, but I'm just going to probably, after I'm done talking about stuff, just kind of give you a sample of the post-recording that I have to do, because there are going to be a little bit of different changes because of the setup I have to use now. But unfortunately, all the videos from now on will have to be post-recorded. I do have one session of Warband that I was able to recover, and we'll be uploading that at some point. But for the most part, it's just going to be post-recording from now on, which has benefits and penalties. I mean, look back at like Skippy Eye and Thrace campaigns. Those were post-recorded. Those weren't too bad. So yeah, I guess first announcement is that Numidia did win the Realm Total War vote. Pretty decisively. I think it was like 2-1 over anything else. So we are going to play Numidia, and as you can see, I can obviously record Realm Total War because this is new footage right here. So I can record Realm Total War now, so that is not a problem. So yeah, there are a couple problems that prevented me from recording. I guess we can go into that. First off, the wireless internet sucks. Just put it that way. So my computer, which does not have an A channel, does not have 5 gigahertz connection on the wireless card, pretty much cannot access the internet, meaning I cannot upload anything or have any chance of uploading anything or even wanting to, you know. So that was the first problem. Then I was just like, oh shoot. So I was like, okay, we're gonna have to record stuff on my school laptop, which is what this is. You know, this is school laptop footage, which isn't bad because the processor is actually pretty decent. Graphics might be a little lower and it might be a little laggier at some points, like on the campaign map. I think it's a little laggier, but all in all, it's not too bad. And but yeah. So then I'm like, okay, we'll have to try to record on that. So, you know, this computer is Windows 8. And Windows 8 has a lot of problems with my microphone. So that was the next problem. I'm like, okay, I can't get that. It took me a long time to get the microphone to work. Finally, like 2 or 3 weeks ago, I was able to get the microphone to work. And I'm like, okay, there we go. First step. Got the microphone down. It has to do with the fact that it's only USB 3 ports. And this is a USB 2. And the driver had a very hard time communicating correctly, like the driver wouldn't want to install correctly, but finally able to get it. So as you can hear by my crisp voice, it is definitely working. Yes, but either way, got that solved. So that was problem two. And problem three is this computer does not have stereo mix. And you might be saying, well, Brainlord, I can hear the game volume. Yes, I did fix it. What the heck am I doing? Well, I don't remember what I was doing there. Okay, anyway. Just fun, kind of funny. Oh yeah, I can also triple speed a lot better on this computer because the processor is better. But enough about, what was I saying? Oh yeah, there's no stereo mix, so I have to use, what I have to do now is while I'm recording, I can record, I got Virtual Dub working on this computer, so I can record the screen pretty much the same way as it was before. The color actually looks a little bit better on this computer, I will say. Because the way I had to like format it on the other computer. So the color will be a little bit better. Might be a little... some stuff that is worse. But overall, it seems like it works pretty well. After fiddling with it for a few days, I was able to, you know, kind of reinstate this good settings that I had before. But, yeah, there's no stereo mix, so I have to use Audacity. And Audacity actually has a functionality where you can... where it like automatically like filters in what's going out of the speakers into like Audacity, and then you can record it kind of directly. It's through like a just separate API thing that Windows offers, to Audacity, but you can't pick it up from your other applications, of course, you know. But, yeah, so I'm recording in-game sound with Audacity while I'm recording game footage with Virtual Dub. And you might be saying, well, why can't you live record with that now, because you got everything working right? Well, see, the problem with that is that I only have two USB ports. Uh-huh. This computer only has two USB ports. What that means is I have one for my mouse, because obviously I'm not going to be playing Realm Total War and other... I can't think of a game that I would not play with a mouse. That I play. I'm trying to think. It's not happening. It's... A mouse is key. So, definitely need a mouse for everything. So that's one USB slot, permanently. And you might be saying, okay, you got another one. It's like, but I have an external hard drive that is USB. And I have to have that. You know why I have to have that? Because this computer is solid state. Meaning that the drive is relatively pretty small compared to the one on the other one. Oh, get him. Get him! Yeah, so, the hard drive is pretty small compared to the other computer, meaning I can't locally record, plus it locally recording would slow down anyway, so it's more efficient to record it on the external hard drive. So that means I cannot record my voice while I am playing unless I figure out a way to, like, get a USB splitter or something, or record on a separate device, or on the, I don't know. For such a temporary thing, because I'm gonna be at school for another like month and a half, and then next semester for like 4 months. So, and then past that, I hope to get my own place, and you know, probably, hopefully have internet that I can use there, and all that good stuff. I'll probably be getting a good rig to use for recording and stuff. So yeah, there is that going on. Yeah, so that was kind of the last few months for me, is trying to figure that out. Plus, you know, it's not like that was my only focus in life. I have school to worry about. I got all kinds of other things I got to worry about, certain for a job and, you know, other activities, extracurricular. So, yeah. It's been a long semester so far, but it's over halfway done, and we are cruising. We are kicking some booty. So I'm not too worried about it, eh? You know what I'm saying, man? You know what I'm saying. So, yeah, we got this working now. So I guess we talk about current plans. I do plan to start the Numidian campaign at some point. What I'm probably going to end up happening is I'm probably just going to record a bunch of footage of different things that I'm playing. Because Monday and Wednesday mornings especially is when I can record a lot of stuff. Because my roommates are gone and... You know, I don't have anything going on those mornings. So I can get a lot of recording done then. But it's in the morning, so I'm not usually, like... It's actually almost better, because I'm not usually motivated to voice record in the morning. So it would be kind of hard for me to, like, voice record. And give good commentary. So, especially if I'm not... As you can probably tell, I'm not very used to this anymore. It's been a couple months. Kind of falling out of the loop of recording, you know? It takes a little conscious thought. It's definitely a different mindset than a non-recording, talking to people, or, you know, just kind of enunciating everything as loud as you can in a clear voice is a different thing. So there's that. Yeah, Numidian campaign is the new thing we're going to do, and it's going to be hosted on this computer. It'll probably be still going on. Well, I don't know. If I do end up recording the whole thing before Christmas break, I guess that's a thing, but I don't know. Might have to transfer it to the other computer and might, you know, change quality halfway through and stuff, but you know, that happens, and you can not worry about that too much. And this army's about to get smoked. You ready? Boom. Oh, you gonna run away? Well, I'm gonna catch up. Oh, boom! Boom. Time to kill. Oh, get him. Get him. Alright, so... Yeah, especially post-recording. I haven't done it in a long time. That requires a different set kind of mentality. You kind of have to remember what's going on. And kind of telegraph things without spoiling things. And, but that's a problem on my end. You guys don't have to worry about that. should be hopefully about the same quality as usual. Or as usual as it was. Warband will continue. Found out how to export saves and, well, it's not actually that hard, but exported the saves to this computer so I can play it on this computer. I do have a, I did a little bit of tinkering with the game, because, you know, I'm a tinkerer. I'm a programmer, so I like tinkering with things, especially computer-related things. So, there is a new mod that gives a new armors, new high-level, high-class armors, but we don't have to worry about that now, of course. This isn't even the right game to talk about that, but yeah, Warband will be continuing. I don't remember, because, like I said at the beginning, I do have that extra session from the summer, from before I went back, that I haven't uploaded yet. We'll upload that, and we'll see where we're going. And we're actually pretty far into the game, and we're getting pretty close to done with that. Past that, we're probably just going to focus on Rome Total War Numidia, because everything else that I have to set up is going to just going to take too long, and I'll probably just have enough time to do probably just that. So I might finish up Warband within the next couple months or so. I don't know. I'm not sure. We'll see. Over Christmas break, I am getting wisdom tooth surgery and that'll put me out for like a week, so that'll be kind of unfortunate. So there's that. Trying to think of anything else to really talk about. Oh yeah, hundreds of, I do have a 1,000 subscriber special I was planning. I still have the plans for it. I was hoping to get it done before I went back to school. That didn't happen. I got part of the way through. I got the music, background music done. I got the concepts kind of done, but I don't have the other stuff ready. I won't spoil too much about what it is, of course, but it should be glorious, and hopefully that'll be something that I may work on. Hopefully get that up at some point. Probably get that up when I have like 2,000 subscribers, haha. Yeah, thank you to all you guys that have joined up since in the past couple months, and sorry I haven't been uploading anything, but hopefully this kind of makes sense. And while it was unfortunate, I hope to be a little more punctual. I guess as far as upload schedule, I guess you can expect from me, while I'm at school, maybe 1, 2, 3 videos a week. Probably 3 isn't tops. Maybe more. I don't know. Depends on the week. Depends on how I'm feeling about, you know, recording. Because post-recording, I have to be consciously ready to record and stuff. So that, it really depends how I'm feeling on the day. And on the week and how busy I am, other stuff going on. So try to get at least 1 video out per week. I think I can do that pretty easily. Especially if I'm recording stuff in the morning, I'll have the footage. So I don't have to worry about playing the game. Because sometimes I just don't feel like playing the game. You know, and that's why, like, in the past, I've had, you know, problems recording and uploading, because I just don't feel like playing the game. You know, like, I'm at school, I'm doing other things, I just don't feel like playing a mentally demanding game at some points, but sometimes I do, and I'm feeling, I guess I'm at that point in my life right now, where I feel like playing demanding things. I feel like using my brain aggressively. So, there's that. I guess that's pretty much all I have to say. So I think I will start post-recording, or start narrating what's going on. After I sneeze! Oh my gosh! Sorry about that. Excuse me. But, yeah, so thanks for watching, and if you want, keep watching, and hopefully enjoy this footage. And hopefully there'll be more to come soon. So, I'm not dead! And neither is this channel, so do not worry. Do not worry, citizens of the internet. It is not over. We are coming back in stride. So, alright. Build some rams here. Gonna siege Carthago Nova. If I had to guess, I'm going to say a guy on the boat is going to attack, but we are on a river crossing, which is very advantageous. Oh, there we go. Of course, I knew that because I already recorded. It's kind of hard to start right in the middle, but, ooh, he's got elephants, ooh, and he's the faction leader, so he's decently strong, and they got the reinforcements, of course, probably mostly Iberian infantry, because it's just pretty much what they can train over here, maybe some round shields, because this is a large town, I believe, So, could have some of those in there as well, you see. Ah, see, this is the nice river crossing.
We did not look for this war. The gods know our hearts, and the gods know the enemy are doomed.
Yeah. Gotta put that in there. I gotta stop talking about what I forgot and what I didn't forget. But, basically, yeah, I did. Also had to keybind, change the keybindings on Rome Tor, on this game, Rome Total War. That's what it is, Rome Total War, yes. That's what this game is. I guess while we're lining up, I can talk about kind of what I was doing. Generally, I'm just kind of doing like a Spanish bum rush. I just wanted to do like a quick little test to see if I could, because I was having trouble with a virtual dub. Was like desyncing a little bit, so I was trying some settings out, and I got a short video to work pretty well. So I decided, okay, let's do like a, you know, feature length video. Usual video is about 30 minutes long, so I got to think of something to do. I poured over Rome this morning, got it working on this computer, and then decided, you know what, let's do like a Spanish bum rush, which just take the two Carthaginian towns, just kick Carthage out of Iberia, really quick. You know, so that's what I decided to do, and that's pretty much what this video is. As you can tell, I wasn't like building any buildings or like paying any attention to my settlements, so it's not like this is like a super serious thing. Just a couple battles, and a couple towns taken. But yeah, I had to remap my key bindings because this computer does not have a number key and does not even have a pseudo number key. Pseudo number key, usually on computers that don't have number keys, they'll have highlighted like JKLM, comma period, and like UIO or something. You know, like some form of 9 keys on the right side of the keyboard, and you can like hold function, or there'll be a num lock that you can do, and when num lock is engaged, it's used as a number key or a number pad instead of those keys that it usually is. Only problem with that usually is that the keys over there aren't, you know, they aren't flush with each other, like in perfect columns, because usually the first row, because tab is usually shorter than caps lock, and then shift is usually the longest one, so they're all kind of like, they're kind of staggered a little bit, so it's kind of hard, it's a lot harder to use, but it is a thing that some computers have. But this one doesn't even have numlock, so this computer does not even have numlock. I guess nobody really used it, so I guess they decided to incorporate it. Or it wasn't used enough, or they didn't care about it or something. But, gotta take a drink, jeez. Excuse me. Choking on the water a little bit. Ooh. Forgot how, throat demanding this is. Is that the right word? Throat demanding. I believe so. But yeah, I had to change, so I made it so that I kind of gave it Rome 2 Total War controls, because I've played Rome 2 more recently than I played Rome, actually. So I just gave WASD for basic camera movement and Q and E rotate the camera. And I played around with it. If you like that, it feels pretty good. It's a very natural position to kind of have your fingers on WASD and then have your left fingers on WASD and your right fingers, you know, using the mouse. I think that works pretty well. So, yeah, we're gonna have a little bit of slinger fight here. I was hoping to get the first hit off, but we kind of shot shots at the same time. And since I'm playing on a harder difficulty, there, of course, we're gonna win. And I'm also in a tighter formation, so that's kind of pretty dumb by me, I will say. So I was just like, okay, we're not gonna win that. Let's focus on hitting the troops coming over. Let's put them in loose formation. Focus on the elephants, because elephants are dangerous. As the first Iberian infantry approaches and gets gutted by our Scutarii, and by our mercenary Scutarii, who are just gutting them with their pila, with their javelins. Because that's what they do. And we got javelin men on the left flank as well, so we're adding extra fire support. They're hitting the enemy in right now. They have a little bit longer range than the pila of the Scutarii, but they do their job well. We're going to give them stop firing. We're going to wait for the elephants to come up. They're still back there quite a bit, so not going to shoot the elephants. Let's just look at their army crossing there. Look at the dead bodies in the river. Get wrecked, you stupid Carthaginians. That's what you get. And I guess they're not really fighting at our Rhodian slingers anymore. Or Balearic. They're Balearic. Slingers, my bad. But okay, their general's getting in here. He's doing a lot of damage to that Scutari unit. So let's have all of our infantry engage the general actively. Yeah, they are getting a lot of routes, but their general's still fighting strong. Let's get our general units in here to do some more work. Oh, we killed their king. There we go. Nice job. And looks like they're... What the heck is our infantry doing? Whatever. We're getting our cavalry in here to clean things up. Tell the infantry to stop goofing around and get in here and clean things up. Oh, I guess they're chasing the one horse, I guess? I don't know. But their elephants are still eager, it says. The elephants are still eager, so we do have to watch out for that. Oh no, they're routing. Did it? Went from eager to routing. Huh. But, kind of dangerous to have it. I wouldn't actually do this. I wouldn't actually have my generals go and take out, like in an actual campaign, I would not have my generals go and take out elephants like this. Because when the elephants fall down, they kill units, you know, around them because they fall on them. And that includes your generals. So there's a good chance that I will lose a general if I do this. Or there's not, I guess it's not a good chance. But see, there it is. We lost one. What am I talking about? Metuginus. He died because an elephant landed on him. And that's the kind of stuff that I would not want to do in a campaign. I'd send my round shields in instead. Because it's important that you kill the elephants. Yeah, you want to kill them if they're routing. If you can. That's important. But you don't want to get your generals killed. Generally bad practice. So, with that army defeated, Carthago Nova is not undefended. But it is lessly defended. Enemy army routes, blah blah blah, blah blah, let's attack Carthago Nova. Normally I probably wouldn't siege attack this one either. Well, I don't know. I was debating about that, like, when I was playing it. I was like, would I siege attack in this situation? Because I'm just bum rushing, so of course I'm going to siege attack. But would Braidenlord actually siege attack in this scenario? My old self would say no. But my newer self would say maybe. More risky kind of play. Yeah, if you watch like Pontus and even like Gaul, you kind of see my old way of playing. Where I was just very passive aggressive. Where we just go all out, we march into enemy territory, we siege a city, and we just stand there. Wait for them to attack, sally forth, or, you know, stuff like that. But I think now I'm more willing to take good siege attacks when they arise. Especially early in the game, where it matters more. Where having that extra territory for a few more turns can actually have a huge impact. As far as, like, income and retraining and other stuff. As well as not having your army exposed, because being inside the walls is a lot easier to protect yourself than being outside the walls. There are pros and cons, I suppose. But this is my usual siege formation that I do. I have my ram guys in front, then I have the ranged units with infantry backup behind them, and then I have my cavalry in the far back. The ranged units will hit the guys over the walls, ideally, which is why they're close up front. Of course, the rams have to be up front, because they're going to be ramming the walls down. I mean, why would you not want the rams in front then? It's kind of their porpoise, man. Kind of the point. But, stupid Iberian infantryman. So yeah, I guess for people that haven't seen Rome Total War, because that is possible. There probably are quite a few people on the channel that haven't seen me play Rome Total War if they haven't gone back and watched my old videos. But, yeah, I did heavily mod Rome Total War. Like, a lot of balance changes, basically. So, if you're wondering why you don't see, like, Town Militia for me or the, Carthaginians, that's why. I pretty much made all the Tier 1 units a little bit better. Well, some of them. Like, Militia Hoplites were OP, so I didn't change them. Basically, I didn't really nerf anything, I just made everything stronger, because that's what I like. I don't like nerfing, I like boosting. You know? That's more fun. So I boosted the strength of, I got rid of Town Militia, and basically I shifted Carthaginian and Spanish infantry down. So for the Spanish, the Scutari are now in the Tier 2 barracks, Iberian infantry in Tier 1. And then the Bulwars are actually, I moved from the temple into the Tier 3, and then I gave the Spanish Naked Fanatics, I believe, in the temple instead of Bull Warriors. Did I? I don't remember exactly. Something like that, but, yeah, basically made the Spanish barracks more effective. Look at this clump, what the heck are they doing? Same thing with Carthaginians, moved all their infantry down. Sacred bands I threw into the barracks as well, instead of being in a temple. So it goes Iberian infantry, Libyan spearmen, Polony infantry, and Sacred Band in their barracks, which works out pretty good. Numidia did extensive modding too, adding, you know, making the Numidian legionaries better and available earlier. You know, I gave them elephants, a couple of other improvements. I changed around a couple of the names to make it more fitting. Generally speaking, pikemen I improved for the most part, because pikemen seemed a little bit weak, in my opinion, as far as, like, you know, the pikes are good, but once you get into melee, they kind of just suck, and they're really weak versus missile attack. I'm like, I don't know. They shouldn't be that weak. Especially, like, the, just graphically, like, the, some of them seem like they should have better shield skill, so I gave a lot of them better shield skill, and stuff like that. Barbarians I kind of reworked a lot. I gave them, I used the models from Barbarian Invasion, actually, and I gave them a large city. All Barbarian factions now have a large city. Gave them stone walls. Gave them... Did I give them... I think, yeah, I gave them two basic sewer systems. Gave them a bunch of tier 4 buildings. That would have been a large city using models. From there, also gave them each nation, like, Barbarian Elite, like, once you get a large city as a barbarian nation, you can train barbarian elite at from your large city. It gets unlocked through upgrading it to large city. The fourth level city improvement building, but whatever I called it, that's what I have them trained at. And then basically they're just like really good units, but they're really small size compared to other units. So it's just like really small veteran, really good units. I think it was kind of interesting to do, because I wasn't going to take the time to like add new units to the tier 4s. That would take forever, but yeah. I'm trying to think of other distinct things I did. I changed around to Starni for the Thracians. I made them a little bit, I think they're better. I kind of did the same thing I did with Barbarian Elite with them, as far as making them a smaller unit but making them more powerful. Now they're pretty good, I would say. But you don't want to train a full army of Bastarni, because you're going to have way too little men. But they're really good if you can, like, if you can hold the Phalanx Pikemen and surround with Bastarni. Let's see. What other kind of stuff I did? Gave the Greek cities Macedonian cavalry, which they already had a unit icon for, which is surprising. It surprised me. It made me think that they wanted to do that, but then they took that out for something. Yeah, we saw that in a Greek campaign that was in there. As well as adding... What did I add? Barbarian Noble Cavalry to the Thracians, that's right. Because their later generals are Barbarian Noble Cavalry, or Barbarian Chosen Cavalry. So I was like, should have Barbarian Heavy Cavalry. Because that seems more fitting. I'm just kind of like probing around the world in my head, thinking about what I changed. I changed the Britons a little bit, gave them a couple more units. I gave them Gallic cavalry, called them like Gallic auxiliaries. So they have one unit of light cavalry. Every nation has cavalry now. The Britons were the only ones to not have cavalry before, which was a huge hindrance. I mean, chariots count, I guess, technically, but... There's some things that just having horse-mounted riders can, you know, it really helps with. So yeah, this was a bad mistake by me, because I didn't really care, to be honest. But I kept rushing my cavalry in way too quickly, and the cavalry started getting gutted pretty hard. And then something horrible happened as we attacked the skirmishers. Killed their general. And then magically... My king gets dehorsed and insta-killed on the charge. And that can't happen in this game. A horse attacking any unit with any kind of spear, that counts javelin too, can get immediately killed upon a charge. So that's why usually when I charge generals in, I use the Krive command. It keeps the general's actual model behind the initial charge, and usually he doesn't end up charging the unit. So it keeps him alive more percentage of the time. And as you can see, my whole column of infantry and cavalry over there is routing. So, yay. It's exactly what I wanted. Because losing your king is very, very hard on morale. Especially because he was a really good commander too, so they just lost all that command rating. Yeah. And these units aren't very good, and we're on a hard difficulty. So, it's not good. It's just not good. So yeah, I'm happy to be recording again. Gotta get used to it again, gotta get used to talking, get used to doing other stuff. I'm thinking, for some other stuff, I might upload some games of League of Legends as well, because that is a game I do play a good amount. Or I've been trying to play a good amount. I'm trying to get a little bit better at that, and especially if I'm not talking during it, I think I'll be able to concentrate better. Of course, I'll be able to concentrate better, but, you know. I'll be more willing to record, and then I can, like, post-record later, talk about what I did, you know, what I was thinking in the moment. Or just kind of make general comments on what I was doing, like, as an observer later, like, what I'm doing wrong and stuff. I think that'd be interesting, because that's a game I enjoy. And I usually what I upload is stuff that I enjoy, so usually how it goes. I like letting you guys have some input, but generally speaking, at the end of the day, I'm not going to play a game that I don't like playing. And that is that on that measure. But yeah, fortunately, our general's bodyguard units are actually just beast moding everything and killing them anyway. So even though our whole infantry body routed pretty much, our heavy infantry body, we still have the barbarian infantry and some other crap. But you know, our good units routed, but our general bodyguard is really good. Carthaginian culture bodyguards are probably the second best behind the Roman ones. Actually, I don't know. Carthaginian bodyguards, I'd say, are almost better. I think they have one more attack point. I don't remember the stats exactly. But they are pretty darn good. Especially because this guy, the guy on the right, started with a silver promotion, which adds +4/+4. So that is very good, of course. Very powerful. Very deadly. Indeed. Look at these slingers just standing against the wall, like,
oh, I wonder if they should turn around and attack the other guys here. Yeah, I don't know why I'm using a Kermit voice. Maybe because they're green.
In clear victory, we have dominated the settlement. So yeah, that was pretty much all I wanted to kind of talk about today. A little video showcasing some Rome Total War on this computer and talking about, you know, future plans and stuff. But I think that's all we're going to do today on Bread Noise Channel, so I guess I'll see you when New Media comes out or some other videos. So, bye.